Blessed Friday to us. While we constantly seek for the mercy of God, as given through the narrative of the vocation or the call of Saint Matthew, and as I am always fond of playing on the words and understanding and, you know, getting to the roots of it, the name Matthew is actually gift of the Lord. So the giftedness that Saint Matthew is representing is not only through the example that he gave by leaving his post, customs post, because as a tax collector, he was considered publicly as a sinner. Apart from following the Lord, he also devoted his time in such a way as to listen carefully to his words. No? He was, of course, according to the list of the apostles, he was the only one, or presumably the only one, to know how to write. No, that's why he wrote a gospel. And how did he write it? Or from which perspective? It is through his listening carefully to the Lord, being close to him. And this is also at the same time crossing over to the beautiful message of the Word of God in today's first reading. God will send a punishment to the people because of their sins in the form of a famine. But what is this famine? It is a famine of the Word. No? Ang kagutom sa pulong, which is actually recognized in today's responsorial psalm. No? The quotation from Deuteronomy chapter 8 verse 3, which also Jesus used when he was tempted by the devil to turn the stone into bread, that not man does, the man cannot live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. So this famine of food is not only food for the stomach, it's food for the mind, it's food for the spirit, it's food for the soul. And this is what Saint Matthew has provided us, or has given us as a gift. Being a gift of God, he also is a gift to us. And the very beautiful gift to us that Saint Matthew has given is the very gospel according to Saint Matthew. And it is another challenge for us to understand and really go through the depths of the very gospel itself. And I think that's also the very reason why it is the first gospel of the New Testament, or in the New Testament, because it has to be read first in order to get to know Jesus more. No? As we say in the song, day by day, oh dear Lord, no? Teach me to see you more clearly, to love you more dearly, and to follow you more closely, day by day. Amen.